So I know that this is the last session, and I'm standing in between you and the happy hour drinks. So I'm going to try to keep this short and sweet and hopefully entertaining as well. So a few words about myself. So my name is Sabrina Yuan. I'm Vice President for Strategy and BD for CARIAD. All right. So who are we? Probably you've never heard of us, but for sure you've heard of all these car brands. And we are the tech company and software division for the for Volkswagen Group. So from left to right, that's Skoda, Seat, Audi, Volkswagen, Porsche, Lamborghini, Bugatti, and Bentley. So these are the brands we're developing software for, and also the car tech stack. Here for this audience today, I'm only going to talk about infotainment and in-cabin experience, because I think this is what you're interested in. And what's going on in our life? So today, we're always connected, right? I see tablets, phone, laptop everywhere. And personally, I have 2 phones, 2 tablets, 2 laptops. So 70% of my waking time, I'm probably at least on 1 screen. Right, so my 3-year-old, like one of the sentences he always say is "put down your phone, mama," is like something that he regularly says. This is how connected we are these days. And then we're looking at e-mobility and automated driving. So traditionally that everybody drives their own cars, but what we're seeing recently in the automotive industry is we're moving towards more of the automated driving functionality. So today, a lot of the cars you see on the road already have hands-free driving, at least on highways, and then we're moving towards of more automated space. What does that mean is we're changing the user behavior of the cars. And of course, that today, if we're talking about electric cars, then it is a big device running by software. It has nothing, principally, it is the similar thing as the tablets and the phone you're using today. So there's new use cases and development in automotive industry. How many of you are driving electric vehicles? Yes. So today, if you're driving, I have an EV as well. So you're definitely using the public charging space. And it's very different from like 5 minutes driving in and out from a gas station. Even for the fast charging, you're probably going to stay there for 30, 40 minutes, right? Of course, you can be on your phone. But a lot of the time that we see our customer wanting more integrated entertainment experience there, because you have a good sound system, you have different screen set right now in your cars, right? I've seen different screens from like a gigantic center console screen to split screen for the passenger and the driver. And now we've seen also this panoramic big screen in front of the car, right? I'll show you one of our concept cars as well down. So on average, every US driver spend about 46 minutes per day in their car. And by 2030, 30% of all vehicles will be electric. So what does that mean? That means all these new cars were equipped with newer software, newer solutions as well. And also by 2030, we will see also more advanced driving assistance system on the car, free driver from driving only experience. And we talk about charging, right? Why we think e-mobility changed in-car media usage? A lot of time, we also notice that people who buy EV are also more tech forwarding, meaning that they are more prone to adapt new technology and also new solutions, right? And today, we also see the development in hardware and software, which will enable more innovative solution into our in-cabin experience as well. So today, probably every one of you have used music streaming service in your car, but down the road, we're seeing, So we're seeing video streaming, gaming, right, health, well-being, and also social media to be part of the standard offering in our future cars as well. So new features. In this segment, I'm going to show you some fun features, and I have to say the the Chinese colleagues of ours are leading the way. So first is the move to multimodal solution within the cabin. So what does that mean is basically we are using the voice recognition, facial recognition, ray tracing, and integrating all of these into the in-cabin experience, right? Intelligent assistance. So you see this little little guy over there. So this is giving the virtual assistants a little bit more character. And then operating system. We've seen different operating system at CARIAD. We are building based on the Android automotive system. And of course, app for dashboard. So this is similar as what you've seen on your phone. And display, we've talked about display. So this is this one big vertical, horizontal display actually across the whole dashboard. And previously, most of the time, when we're looking at the display, we're more thinking about the drivers. Now, the display is also extended to the passenger seat so that there's different entertainment options that we can offer for the passenger as well. Of course, there are also backseat screen that we're seeing in the industry. All right, how many of you have seen it when you were driving? I love to sing in my car because I think the acoustic is quite good inside of a car, right? And of course, you can also utilize the sound system already installed in your car. So this is the fun offering that we've seen in China is actually a microphone integrated into a karaoke application in your car. And so what about us? So Volkswagen Group. Two things. One is we are moving solidly towards electrification. So if you've seen our open commitment is by 2030, we're targeting about 80% of our cars to be EV in Europe and 55% in America. So what does that mean? So in 2012, that Volkswagen has delivered 9 million cars worldwide. Right, and if we're calculating that number, then Volkswagen will become the world's largest EV manufacturer down the road. And also that means that we're putting more tech stack into our newest generation electric vehicle, which we are creating that in-cabin experience for our customer. All right, so hope this plays. So this is a very engineering way of showing the concept. So this is our digital assistance concept, and this is created for the engineering crowd to see. Now I'm going to show you a concept car that we've shown at Pebble Beach last summer. So this is Grand Sphere made by Audi. And this is actually not too far-fetched from production car in a couple of years. And yes.
Welcome. Here is an overview of your trip. Takeover. Manual mode activated.
This video is more animated than I would wish for, because our concept car we showed at Pebble Beach was actually fully functional. So all the function you've seen here that you can experience in the function car. I actually had I have a video of that retractable steering wheel, but of course my video is not production quality, so they're not allowing me to show here. If you're interested, come find me, I'll show you. Of course, we're a very German company, so that means progress through technology. All right, and content. So we are, of course, very much interested in working with our content provider and also content creator. So this is one of the joint design project that we did with Lucasfilm designers and for the Star Wars movie. How many of you like the dark side version or the light side one? Personally, I kind of like the dark side better. Gaming. So this is our creation for the Gran Turismo. So this is a Porsche show car for the Gran Turismo game. And this is not a production vehicle, and we're also not developing into a production vehicle. But this is a very popular concept that we did for the game, and it was well received in the gaming community. All right, now I'm going to show you something fun. And this is not a concept. It is in production, and you can get it already on the market.
Thank you. there already?
So this is the product we co-developed with our partner, Holoride, right? So if you ever played a VR game, that you know that part of the problem is always motion sickness, right? So why is that? Because our brain basically think that we're moving, and in reality, physically, we're not. And then the more our brain gets confused, the more motion sickness we get. So this is not a simple plug-and-play VR headsets. So what we do is we actually sync it with the car movement. So you play it when the car is moving. And so also the game that you play, when the car turns, when the car driving at a certain speed, the sort of body feel you have is synced with the car motion. So that way we're reducing the motion sickness when you play the car. Of course, today that you can only play it when you're on passenger seat. If you are looking to buy, this is an offering on our Audi e-tron Sportsback. All right, so what's next? We're talking about Android operating system. So by 2026, about 40 million vehicles will be equipped with Android operating system for the infotainment. So 40 million vehicles, 40 million is not a small number for any industry, and for automotive, this is definitely a considerable number. And why Android Automotive OS? So today, if you're using the projection mode, meaning that if you plug your phone into your car and then it shows up on your head unit, then this is a projection mode. And what we are talking about is a native operating system, so no smartphone required, and operates directly in the head unit. And we can skin it differently for different car brands. Of course, if you think about a Volkswagen brand customer brand cars versus a Bentley brand cars, well, the touch and feel needs to be different, right? And we can also enhance the user experience and the use of vehicle functions differently through the operating system. Why I'm talking about operating system, I'm not here to promote Android, right? Because if any of you are already having a streaming application which works on an Android tablet, and then you're already 80-90% there if you want to integrate it into our vehicle infotainment system, into our app store. And so we can utilize templates. And also, I'm here to inviting all of you to co-create and also brainstorm with us for the new business model, for the new customer offering for the next generation automotive. What's our solution? So we are launching our CARIAD in-car app store this summer, first with Audi, and we'll gradually roll out with all car brands within Volkswagen Group, and there will be new brands coming as well. And I think some of you have heard Scout announcement. This is a new American brand that we're bringing to the market. And so that's also part of the brand that we're supporting. And that's it. So if you're interested, come talk to me. I'll stick around for the happy hour. And the QR code is going to redirect you to our partner website from Harman. So we co-developed the app store with Harman. Harman is a long time partner with us. All right. Thank you very much. And enjoy the happy hour. There will be people guide you through. It's on the third floor.